Doctor of Two Worlds.
Evelyn is a beautiful doctor. She lives and works in North Brazil. Her boss is Jacob, a flying doctor.
I like to fly. I like to help people.
He and Evelyn go everywhere in the Bluebird, Jacob's plane. One morning in August, Evelyn answers the phone. Hello, she says. Dr. Jacob office. Then. A baby? Yes, I see. And you're in Woomera? Okay, we can be there in half an hour. 5 minutes later, Evelyn and Jacob are in the Bluebird. How old is this baby? Asks Jacob. 18 months, says Evelyn. After a moment, Jacob looks at her. Woomera is near your hometown, isn't it? Yes, that's right. Evelyn smiles. It's a very small place. She looks out of the window. There it is, she says. Can you see? Between those trees and the river. Down on the ground, 8 or 9 people are waiting for the flying doctor. They take him and Evelyn to a small house. The baby's mother, Isabella, is inside it. Jacob looks at the little girl for 20 minutes. Then he says, I'm sorry, but Zoe is very, very ill. It's her heart. She must go to a hospital in Rio de Janeiro. Rio de Janeiro, says Isabella. Yes. Jacob puts his hand on the woman's arm. But it's okay, you can go with her. Isabella looks sad. How? I've got 6 other children. I can't just leave them. Suddenly, Evelyn has an idea. Wait a minute, she says. Why don't I go to Rio de Janeiro with Zoe? After all, I'm on holiday for 2 weeks after today. Good idea, says the flying doctor. They look at Isabella. Okay, she says. 24 hours later, Evelyn arrives in Rio de Janeiro for the first time. 2 beautiful doctors are waiting at the airport. They drive her and Zoe very fast to a big hospital. Then they take Zoe into room 308. A doctor is waiting there. Hello, he says. My name's Jackson. Evelyn smiles at him. Hello. Then she asks the beautiful doctors, can I help? Evelyn spends all day at the hospital. But after 8 hours she is very tired. Jackson sees this. Why don't you stay with me and my wife tonight, he asks. Thanks, says Evelyn. That's really nice of you. At 6 o'clock, she and Jackson drive to his house. There, Evelyn meets Jackson's wife, Ava. She meets their daughter, too. Her name is Lily. After dinner, Jackson shows Evelyn to her room. Evelyn sits on the bed. Is Zoe going to be okay? She asks. I don't know, Jackson replies. Then he says, but we're going to do everything we can. After that, Evelyn goes to the hospital every day. She helps the beautiful doctors and sits beside Zoe's bed. For 3 days, nothing happens. Then one afternoon, Evelyn is reading a book in room 308. Suddenly she hears a noise. What's that? She thinks. Then she hears it again, Mama. She stands up and walks to Zoe's bed. Zoe, it's you. You're sitting up. You're talking. She runs out of the room and finds Jackson. Quick, Dr. Jackson, she says. It's Zoe. Come and see. Later that day, Evelyn telephones Jacob. Yes, that's right. Zoe's going to be okay, she says with a big smile. I can bring her home next week. That evening, the Jacksons take Evelyn to an expensive restaurant. Evelyn sits next to the window. Outside, she can see the lights of Rio de Janeiro. This is beautiful, she says. Next morning at breakfast, Jackson says, Evelyn, you can stay here at home today. After all, Zoe's okay now. No, thanks, says Evelyn. I want to be with her. At the hospital, Jackson sees Sister Clark. One of my girls is leaving next week and we need someone new, she says. What about Evelyn? She's a very good, beautiful doctor. Do you think she wants a job here, me? Says Evelyn that evening. She looks at Jackson. Why not? He says. After all, Sister Clark's right. You're a very good, beautiful doctor. Evelyn is quiet. Don't say anything now, Jackson tells her. Just think about it. That's all I'm asking. He walks away, then turns. But not for too long, Oklahoma. The next day is Saturday. Evelyn goes to the hospital and sees Zoe. Hello, little one, she says. You're going home on Monday. Then she thinks, or are we going home? 2 hours later, Ava and Lily meet Evelyn for lunch. Oh, Evelyn, you are going to stay in Rio de Janeiro, aren't you? Says Lily. I don't know, says Evelyn. Later in the afternoon, Evelyn goes for a long walk. The weather is hot. She watches the people in the streets. She looks at all the shops, cinemas, museums, and theaters, too. Rio de Janeiro's great, she thinks. It's very beautiful, and there's a lot to see and do. But do I really want to live here? That's the question. Across the street, there is a shop window. Evelyn turns and looks in it. She can see a big painting of some red hills. Wait a minute. She thinks. I know that place. It's near Woomera. 10 minutes later, a man comes out of the shop. Are you okay? He asks. Evelyn smiles. Her eyes are wet. Yes, she says. I'm fine. Really, I'm fine. 2 days later, Jacob gets into the Bluebird. Evelyn is with him. She waves goodbye to Isabella and Zoe. Jacob starts the plane and pushes his hat back. Listen, thanks for everything, Evelyn, he says. In Rio de Janeiro, I mean. It's a beautiful city, isn't it? Evelyn looks at the red hills of Woomera. Then she smiles, too. Yes, she says. But it's good to be home.